my respected ulama, respected muftita, my respected elders and my brothers, and my little ones, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, I thank yourselves, the people of Batley, for inviting me. And especially the Rabita and the ulama that are associated with the Rabita. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps them taking the khidmat of deen from these ulama and accepts their effort. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes this khidmat of deen from you and I. And I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our efforts. Beautiful words have already been said before me. Mawlana Hasim Saab, and thereafter followed by Hazrat Mufti Saab. What would beautify these words even more is that if we place them inside our hearts, and then watered these words by bringing them into our daily life and acting upon them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرْ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرْ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لَمَنْ يَشَاءُ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive the sin of shirk, associating anything, any person with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter forgives whatever He wishes to whoever He wishes. Further, the Quran says, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ, whoever commits the sin of shirk, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ. The Jannah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for the believers, this Jannah becomes haram on this person who commits this sin. And his abode is the fire of hell forever and ever. A man came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَيُّ الزَّمْبِ أَكْبَرُ عِنَّ اللَّهِ. The Messenger of Allah, tell me, which is the sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala detests, hates most of all? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, أَنْ تَدْعُوا لِلَّهِ نِدًّا وَوَ خَلَقًا. But you call upon anyone besides the Almighty Allah, yet it was Allah who created you. The hadith recorded by Imam Muslim and Imam Bukhari in the Sahih, narrated by Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, says that I was mounted on the same animal as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, Ya Mu'adh, أتدري ما حق الله على العباد وما حق العباد على الله. O Mu'adh, do you know the right Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has on his people and the right the servants have on the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He replied, Allah wa Rasuluhu a'lam. But Allah and His Messenger know best. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the right Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has on his people is that they do not commit the sin of shirk and they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the right the people have on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never punish one who does not commit the sin of shirk. Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shall I not give this good news to the people and inform them? Nabiyya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Ya Mu'adh, la tubashshirhum. Do not inform the people about this. Why? because they will rely on this and they will not strive to do good deeds. A final hadith. Sayyidina Mu'az ibn Jabr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was instructed by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Mu'az, لا تشرك بالله وإن قتلت أو قرقت. Mu'az, never commit the sin of shirk. Even if you are killed, do not commit this sin. Even if you are burnt to death, do not commit this sin. I'm sure from these verses of the Quran and these ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you realize that the title allocated for today is Tawheed and Shirk. And you may question, so why has this title been chosen and allocated? Well, alhamdulillah, we are Muslim. Our mothers and fathers are Muslim. Our grandmothers and grandfathers were Muslim. When we believe in the Almighty Allah, when we believe that Allah is our Khaliq, the Creator, when we believe Allah is our Razik, the Provider, when we believe Allah is the Malik, the Sovereign, Allah is the Bestower, Allah is the Maker, Allah is the Fashioner, Allah is the Rahman, Allah is the Rahim, Allah is the Malik, Allah is the Quddus, Allah is the Salam, Allah is the Muhaymin, Allah is the Aziz, the Jabbar, the Mutashabbih. For generations we have declared La ilaha illallah, that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we see the creation of Allah, we realize there is an Allah, and this Allah is one. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. When we look at the heaven and the earth, when we look at the universe, the size of the universe, and what Allah has created in the universe, the sun is 3 million miles away from the earth. It is hundreds and thousands of times bigger than the earth. This is just one star. There are over 200 billion stars in our galaxy, and there are billions of stars in the universe. When we see this, we realize there is an Allah. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. When we look at ourselves, when we look at this brain and the way it has been programmed, when we look at the heart and the way it pumps the blood, when we look at the digestive system, when we look at the nervous system, when we look at these hands, when we look at these feet, when we look at these lips and ears, every limb is so perfect. The water that there is inside the mouth is different to the one that comes out of the ear. The one that comes out of the ear is different to the one that comes out of the eye. The one that comes out of the eye is different to the one that comes out of the nose. Yet the source of all this water is exactly the same. The root is one. When we look, that everybody's eyes are exactly in the same place. Their ears are exactly in the same place. Their lips and mouth is exactly in the same place. Their teeth are in exactly the same place. Their eyelashes and eyebrows are exactly the same place. Yet on the surface of this earth, you will not find two human beings that look exactly the same. When we look at this, we realize there is an Allah. When we look at the animal world, when we look at the bee and the way it produces its honey, when we look at the spider and its perfect web, when we look at these birds that they migrate thousands of miles without any prior experience, without any guide, we realize that there is a programmer, and this programmer is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي الْأَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ وَجَنَّاتٌ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَزَرْعٌ وَنَخِيلٌ صِنْوَانٌ وَغَيْرُ صِنْوَانٍ يُسْقَى بِمَاءٍ وَاحِدٍ وَنُفَضِّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ. When we look at the grapevine, when we look at the green crops, when we look at the date palm, when we look at the apples, when we look at the oranges, they grow from a single stem root, watered with the same water, grow in the same earth. Yet you will never find two apples tasting the same. You will never find two oranges tasting the same. When we see this, we realize there is an Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَالْفُلْكِ الَّتِي تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِمَا يَنفَعُ النَّاسَ وَمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مِن مَّاءٍ فَأَحْيَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. When we look at the alternation of the day and night, when we look at these ships, these huge ships sailing through the seas, carrying thousands of people, carrying thousands of the tons, when we look at the wearing of the wind and the clouds which are held between the heaven and the earth, we realize there is an Allah. We realize there is there is a creator. قل هو الله أحد. And this creator is one. Oh, Malala, when a country cannot be run by two presidents, when any place cannot be run by two management, when a small masjid cannot be run by two presidents, then where can this universe and everything within it be run by two Allahs? لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا فسبحان الله رب الأرض أما يصفون. When we, oh, Malala, when in عالم الأرواح, before we even came to this dunya, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extracted from Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam all his descendants, I was there. And when the Almighty Allah asked me, Alastu bi Rabbikum, am I not your Lord? I testified on that day, oh Allah, you are my Khalik, oh Allah, you are my Malik, oh Allah, you are my Razik, oh Allah, you are my Lord. When I testified in Alam al-Arwah that Allah is my Lord, and today I bear witness, La ilaha